Hi, Tzvi.
Hello.
First of all, I would like to thank all our viewers who stayed for the last 3 hours. The numbers are amazing and so many people are watching us. And thank you, Tzvi, for being part of the last panel of the first day of the summit. So before I start, I want to say for the few people who don't know Tzvi, because it seems like everybody knows you, Tzvi, your research area have been design and analysis of algorithms, complexity, cryptography, and experimental design. You were the president of Tel Aviv University from 2007 through 2009. And from 2010 to 2019, you were the dean of Georgia Institute of Technology College of Computing. So, Tzvi, we have about 10 minutes for our panel, and since you have given many talks before, I want to cover a very specific angle of your work as a manager in an educational institution, and that is execution. Or to put in more direct words, how did you innovate in higher education? So just before we start, can you please share with us, because many people have heard of the MOOC initiative that you did in Georgia Tech, what was the degree and the initiative all about?
Okay, our program is called OMSCS, Online MS, Master of Science in Computer Science, OMSCS. It started in 2014, so it is 6.5 years old. Last semester in spring 2020, we had 9,590, almost 9,600 students. In the fall of 2020, we will pass 10,000 students and possibly reach 11,000 students. We are graduating 1,500 graduates a year. Harvard researcher 3 years ago, when we were the half the size, said that we are the largest master program in computer science in the US, probably the world. And that every year they projected we will produce 7% of the graduates out of 200 universities that award the master degree. In fact, we produce more than 10% of the graduate. Our motto is accessibility through affordability and technology.
Those numbers are amazing.
Features. First is the cost. It's under $7,000. That caused an earthquake. Normal master program in public university costs about $40,000, including Georgia Tech, and in private university, $70,000 and more. The second feature is it's based on the technology of the MOOCs. The third, which is, I think, the most important part, is admission. We have admission criteria. Not everybody is admitted, and we admit everybody that we believe can do it. So in a sense, we admit a little over 70% of the applicants compared to the on-campus program where we admit about 10%. Surprisingly, when both take the same courses, they perform similarly. Sometimes the online students perform a little better. And the four unique feature is that our students make huge use of social media, much more than the on-campus courses. So in this sense, the online courses are much richer. And in this respect, they are much better. And in fact, our student, when they compare it to on-campus courses they took, some of them and many say they are comparable, and some of them say that they are even better.
This is amazing, Tzvi, and the numbers you just share and all your points are truly amazing. Unless you want to add something more, I have
a little bit more. We were the first of this kind, and there are now 40 programs in more than 30 universities that went in our footsteps. And some of them have several programs. And there is just one last comment. the demographics of the online student and on-campus students is very different. The online students are about 10 years older, 32 average age compared to 22. And the online students are mostly domestic. Even though we have students from 120 countries, they are mostly domestic. The on-campus students are mostly international. By the way, I was asked to write the story of OMSCS to communication of the ACM, the magazine of ACM, Association of Computing Machinery, that every one of the 100,000 members get. And coincidentally, it will appear in the August issue, which means next week.
So I guess everybody can read it. And it's amazing. Every time I hear you, and I think I heard your talk many times before, the excitement and your energy really comes out. And every time I learn something new, the numbers are really amazing. Over 10,000 students and accessibility, it's amazing. It's really amazing. But I want to touch with you, if you will allow me, on a very specific point. Execution. Higher ed institution, I work in a higher ed institution for the last 10 years, are not the easiest place to work at. Some might even say they are conservative. How did you manage to innovate in higher education? And I remind you, we have around 5 minutes and I have two more questions. So I want to hear the secret. Is it something you put in the water?
I want to amplify your point. Universities are the second most conservative institution in the world after the Catholic Church. Faculty can be very liberal, but they're not very liberal when we talk about changes in their work conditions. In 2012 was the year of the MOOC. New York Times called it the year of the MOOC. The first MOOC actually was late in 2011. And in September, Sebastian Trunk came and said, Zvi, let's do a master degree based on MOOCs with Udacity. Let's do it for $1,000. As I said, I don't think 1,000 will do, 4,000 will do. But our leadership was a bit cautious, so we did it for under $7,000. But then I wanted to do it, but I'm only the dean, you know. And dean and even a president in university cannot tell the faculty what to do. They will laugh him or her out of the room. So I created a task force that worked on it for 6.5 months. They debated, they had town hall meetings. Sebastian came, me and my executive associate dean, Charles Isbell, who is now the dean, we didn't take part. I told them, if you don't want to do it, we will not do it. I cheated a little bit. I took some faculty that already did MOOCs and liked it. And they came up with the program and they come up with a blueprint with the operational manual. And then 6.5 months later, we had the vote. And the faculty voted 75% to do it. You're right. You cannot do anything in university without the faculty buying. That's my the first and foremost achievement, to get the faculty buying. Another item that is very important when you innovate, when you do something new, when you ask your faculty to do something they have not done before on top of what they are doing, is incentives. It's very important. People will do volunteer for a little bit, but nothing can survive on voluntary basis.
So those were great insights, and maybe for closing, because I can see that you can share so much around these topics. Many of our viewers are K-12 educator and principals. Do you think that they can take something from your experience to their institution?
So first I want to say that I'm not an expert on K-12, but I have something to tell them, several things. So first, for the best students, they probably should be able to take online college courses for credit, Right. That's one thing. Second thing I want to comment to them, remote learning is not exactly online learning. It's mediocre at best. and it's not criticism. Many universities and schools had to move to remote learning overnight. Most of the faculty and the teachers and most of the students never learned online or taught online. So that was kind of amazing, but that's not online learning. What I recommend to the high school principals, innovate, experiment, try to move to the 21st century. Not everything will be successful. Gently try new ways how to enhance the teaching with technology.
Zvi, unless you have another very important insight, I think I start to understand how you innovated and executed in your institution and why this program that you created so much traffic, news and covers in different magazine. And I hope the Quay 12 educator and principal took some of your insights. And I would like to use this opportunity to thank everybody who stayed and watched us. And I promise you tomorrow that we are having another very interesting day with great panelists. We will open the day with Professor Michael Crow that you know personally from Arizona State University. And it's going to be, I hope and believe, another great day. Thank you all for staying so late. And we'll see you all tomorrow. Sweet, do you want to say one last thing?
I want to thank everybody for staying so late for my little bit of introduction of OMSCS. And if you want to know more, you can send me email or you can find my email on Georgia Tech's website. You know, you just Google me.
Thank you, Professor Galil, so much for your time. Thank you.